Are you getting overwhelmed with your SEO reports and all the tools? There's so many out there. Well, don't worry, you're not alone. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down the only features you need to use in SEO tools. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel. If you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. Don't get bogged down by reports and features and tools that do very little to actually get you more rankings. I'm gonna break down four main features and reports that you need to rank higher. And here's best of all. You can do pretty much all of this in Ubersuggest. You can find it at neilpatel.com/ubersuggest, or just go to ubersuggest.com. And you can do literally most of this stuff for free in Ubersuggest. That's what's great. So in essence, we'll go down the four main features you need to use and how you can do it for free. So let's dive right in. Number one, rank tracking. Look, on Google, if you don't know what your rankings are, if they're going up or if they're going down, or how things are improving or declining, how are you gonna improve? Those things are really important, right? Because here's the thing with SEO. It's a long game. YouTube SEO is very different. You can get results within a day or two, believe it or not, even if you have no subscribers and a brand new YouTube channel. But Google SEO is the opposite. A lot of times it can take 3 months, 6 months, even a year plus to see results. But do you want to invest blindly into SEO? Of course not. You want to see, are you getting results? Ideally within a few months, even if your traffic's not going up. And that's what rank tracking does. It'll tell you if you're on page 10 or page 9 of Google or even page 6. And you know this better than anyone else. When you do a Google search, are you really going to page 6, 7, 8, 10? No, not really. You're going page 1, maybe page 2, but you usually stop at page 1 or 2. And if you can't find what you're looking for, you usually do a different search. But even though you're on page 10 and then you move to page 8, you won't really see a traffic increase, but that's progress. And rank tracking shows you that, and it can track your rankings on a daily basis and a weekly basis, whatever you prefer. And you can even track your rankings on mobile devices and desktop. You can do that all in Ubersuggest for free. And what's cool about that is that way you can see how you're performing on different device types. And it tells you when you're doing SEO what's working and what isn't. Because there's so many different factors in SEO, you want to double down on your wins and avoid doing the things that aren't doing as well for you. On top of that, you can also use Google Search Console. Google Search Console allows you to see all the keywords that you're ranking for your content. Because here's the thing, when you're doing SEO and you write blog articles, you have product pages, you're optimizing for some keywords, but a lot of times you start ranking for these long tail keywords that are very popular, such as how to get more Instagram followers, that you would have never thought that could drive a lot of traffic because there's so many words in that query, but it can. And then you can add that to your rank tracking list within Ubersuggest, and you can start optimizing for those terms as well. The second thing that you need to look at with these SEO tools is competitive analysis. Competitive analysis tells you what your competitors are doing and what's working for them. Look, you don't want to recreate the wheel. You want to do what's working for others and just do it better. Why start from scratch? And there's no need. SEO has been around for so long. These days, you can just replicate what's working for your competitors and add a little bit of that special touch so that way you can beat them. So with the competitive analysis on Ubersuggest, you can type in any competitor URL and you can look at top pages. Top pages shows you the most popular articles or pages on your competitor's site. And what's cool is you can see the keywords by clicking on the keywords button, and you'll see all the keywords that that page ranks for. And that'll tell you, hey, should I also create a page that's very similar? Well, if I do, now I know what keywords to go after because it's related to my business and it can also drive me sales. And another cool feature is you can also see all the backlinks that are driven to that page, right? All the other sites that are linking to your competitor's page. Because here's the thing, if someone's willing to link to your competitor, they're probably willing to link to you too. So now you got a list of links going to your competitors so you can create a better page of them that's more thorough, go after all their keywords, and you can also hit up all the people linking to them and ask them to link to you too. The other cool thing that I like about the competitive analysis report on Ubersuggest You can see how much traffic your competitor is getting, if they're getting more traffic month over month or less traffic month over month, because Google's doing so many updates. If you get hit by a major update, you can see if your competitors are getting hit by major updates. You can also see all the keywords that your competitors are ranking for as well. There's a list. You can either do it by top pages, or you can just see a list of all the keywords, and you can see the most popular keywords in order. So now you know what keywords you can potentially focus on. Now, when you're looking at your competitors' keywords, I would also look at the CPC, which Ubersuggest shows you. That stands for cost per click. Even though they're ranking for these keywords organically, if they have a high cost per click, that means people are willing to spend a lot of money on the ad portion, and that means those keywords probably convert really well. And those are ones that you should go after if it's related to your business. The third report that you need to look at and feature within these SEO tools is keyword ideas. Now, the keyword ideas report in Ubersuggest gives you all these ideas that you can go after. In other words, it shows you what people are searching for whenever you type in a keyword, and it'll show you what keywords people aren't searching for. Sometimes I think keywords are gonna be so popular, I type them in and I'm like, only 100 searches a month. I'm glad I didn't go after it, because if only 100 people are searching for that keyword a month, you know, it doesn't mean you're gonna get 100 visits. Being at the top, you only get a fraction of those visits. So you wanna go after popular keywords. And what's cool about the Ubersuggest Keyword Ideas report, you can actually filter based on any region, such as United States or Canada or UK or India or Brazil or even, you know, South Korea. But here's what's also really cool. You can then put in cities like Seoul, South Korea, or you can put in New York, New York, or you can look at it on a state level. And this will tell you all the keywords that are popular within a region in case you have a local business. And within the keyword ideas report, in Ubersuggest, there's also a content ideas report, where it'll show you all the content that you can write about that are related to those keywords. So you can see what's popular on Facebook, what's popular on Pinterest, what's popular from a backlinks perspective, and what's even popular from an organic SEO perspective. The last factor, and this is number four, is backlinks. If you don't get people linking to you, you're not gonna do well. Backlinks are like votes. You know, during a presidential election, the more people that vote for a candidate, the more likely they are to win. Now, you know, I know different countries have different voting systems and there's more to it, but just generally speaking, the more votes someone has, the more likely they are to win for a presidency. The same thing is with Google. But instead of a vote, they look at it as a link. Like if I link to you, that's a vote in confidence saying, hey, Neil's linking to you, or John's linking to you, or New York Times is linking to you. But they also have other factors like the quality of those votes or backlinks. A link from New York Times is way better than a link from Neil Patel. A link from CNN is way better than a link from Neil Patel. So you want to get ideally bigger sites linking to you and more relevant sites. And you can use the backlinks report within Ubersuggest. And what's cool is they have a backlinks opportunity report more specifically, where you can put in your URL and then your competitor URLs, and it'll show you all the people that link to your competitors but don't link to you. Because if someone links to not just one, but two, three, four of your competitors and they don't link to you, the chances are they don't mind linking to other people in your space because they already link to lots of your competitors. Now, if you need help with any of these factors or just your SEO, check out my ad agency, NP Digital, where we help people grow their traffic and get the results for them. If you have any questions, you can always leave a comment below, and I'm here to help. If you enjoy the video, like it, share it. Thank you for watching.